As the Ebola virus continues its deadly march across West Africa, a highly anticipated weapon in the battle against the virus is moving out of the lab.
Yeah, starting next week, human testing is due to begin here in the United States on an experimental vaccine. Joining us with more now, senior medical correspondent Elizabeth Cohen. You know, Elizabeth, tell us about this vaccine. How promising? How long until we know whether it works?
You know, John, it would be so great if we could just get this out there immediately, right? I mean, that would be so amazing. But this process takes time. So first, they have to start with phase one, where they try it out just in a small group, just in 20 people. And let's take a look at some of the basics of what they're trying to do here. They'll be giving this vaccine to healthy volunteers and then measuring whether they see an immune response when they take their blood. They'll be starting at NIH, and then they'll be moving on to trying this out in the UK, Gambia, and Mali. It is one of two leading candidate vaccines. Now, that when question, John, that is so important. I mean, usually this would take years, but they said, look, we're going to finish this first part by late 2014, by late this year, and then we're going to have discussions about whether we want to bring the drug to Africa, like maybe even directly to Africa, which usually they don't do that. Usually they do more testing, but they'll have discussions about when and how they're going to get this to the people who need it.
Certainly some promising news, especially when just today the WHO, the World Health Organization, is announcing that this virus is spreading kind of like wildfire. Startling numbers about how many new cases there are.
It is, and I think what's really so sad about all of this, too, is that there's so much effort. I mean, the World Health Organization, the CDC, so many people are trying to fight this. And take a look at sort of what the results have been so far. If you look at it, there's been more than 1,500 deaths. 3,000 people have gotten sick with this virus, and this is the part that's really so awful. 40% of these cases have occurred in the last 3 weeks. So in other words, this is not getting better. In fact, it appears to be getting worse.
It shows the difficulty, though, you know, sometimes you have in fighting an outbreak like this, because everyone now knows this is going on. Everyone now knows where it's going on, yet it can't be stopped in its tracks, Elizabeth.
John, that's a great way to put it, because so awareness is not the issue. That might have been a part of the issue at the beginning, but, you know, we all know this now. And so one of the issues is fear. I was talking to a CDC worker who was in Africa for a month trying to do contact tracing, and she would ask someone sick with Ebola, sir, you know, tell me, how many people have you been eating? You know, tell me the names of people you've been eating with and who you live with and, you know, who might have had contact with your bodily fluids. And often she would get an answer that would be like, oh, my wife, and that's it. And she knew that it was more than his wife. She knew he had a family, but he didn't want to name people because in his community there was a rumor that if you named someone, they would die. And not only wouldn't they die, would they die, they would die in the order that they appeared on the list. And when you're trying to fight those kinds of misconceptions, it is extremely difficult to contain an outbreak.